Together. Wawese o Royal Court Theatre Troupe. Wawese. Hey, logu wow. Please welcome a U.S. State Senator, Kevin Parker, all the way from New York to attend this grand occasion. The new Oba is almost here, as we can see from the film that is being shown to us. I believe it's something that every man, every woman in Nigeria ought to be proud of. That in spite of being a modern king, in spite of being a 21st century Oba, this Oba has decided to take all the routes to perform all the ceremonies as done in history, as done by his forebears. So it's something that we should really respect him for. And so once again, we want to welcome all our distinguished guests, all our royal fathers who have waited patiently for their brother king. All distinguished guests, we want to thank you again for your patience and to welcome you again to Benin, the land of culture. You have been seeing some of it. Even the rituals that the Oba is engaged in at the moment, they are all part of sustaining the heritage. They are all part of sustaining the culture. And so welcome to Benin, the cradle of civilization, the cradle of culture. Welcome to a land of approximately 1.5 million people, going by the 2006 population census, a people who may have diverse philosophies, diverse ideologies, diverse views about issues, but are united by a unique monarchy. And so please put your hands together for the monarchy. The Benin monarchy unites us all in spite of our diverse views on issues. Very shortly, the monarch will be ushered in by the Ekasa, Royal Dance Troupe. We understand the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, is already close by, is expected to come into this arena with the state governor, Comrade Adams Oshomole. We thank you once again for your patience. Ine Theatre Troupe, if you are close by, please come and entertain. Like I said, there may not be any other time for you to perform within the program, because once His Majesty comes, we'll go straight to the issues of the day. So Inne Theatre Troupe, Ugebesu Wagbeo, Waden Wadoyo Weran Oto, Inne Theatre Troupe.
Our royal fathers, we welcome you one more time, and we are really indeed moved by the color and the glamour of this event. Let me welcome Mr. Denado Coleman from New York and Chief Newton Chuka Jibuna, the world renowned environmentalist, is also here with us as we enjoy the rich culture. And we're also in expectation of His Excellency, the Governor of this state, and the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as part of our rich culture, it is interesting to know that the hierarchy of chiefs, the groupings of chiefs, have continued to perform their roles in this kingdom. We have, on top of the hierarchy, the Edion, which is the Uzama. We have the Uzama Nibie. We have the Egaiwo Noe, We also have Ibiwe Nehua. We have Eraibonogbe, made up of Iwebo, the palace society to which the new monarch had initially been initiated as a daiken. We have the Iwegwai, and we have the Ibiwe. We have other chiefs known as Ekaime.
As the cultural troops are coming in now to take over, we'll carefully go through the names of the coronation planning committee very, very soon. Thank you very much. Thank you. And if you've been looking at the screen, you will see that even the Oba can't even move. The last time I saw this kind of crowd was at the presidential election around President Muhammadu Buhari. This is the people taking ownership of the king. But while we are waiting here, let me very quickly say thank you to the coronation planning committee one more time and go through their names. Let me welcome the chairman of this coronation planning committee. But before I do so, I'd like to welcome all the way from Oyo State, His Excellency, the governor of Oyo State, distinguished Senator Abiola Ajimobi. Your Excellency, we welcome you. We welcome you. Let me quickly acknowledge the the Coronation Planning Committee, I'd like to welcome very specially for the high level of hard work he has put in with his incredible team, His Royal Highness Professor G.I. Kinzua, OON Chairman. I'd like to welcome Prince Agatise Eredioha, Member, Prince Omoregbe Eredioha, Prince Ehiose Eredioha, Princess Mrs. A.C. Emovon, Princess Mrs. Ekewa Ine, Princess Mrs. Ukoyewan Imiowu, General Godwin O. Abe, retired CFR, Ambassador E.E. Imohe, Ambassador Dan Hart. Let me also welcome here Olorogun Moses Tiger, Chief Charles Nwansui Edosanwon SAN, Omori Omonwa SAN OFR, Chief Mike Ozekomen SAN, Chief Austin Alegi SAN, Mr. Ide Egwebo, Honorable Joseph O. Omorotewen, Mr. Arthur Ogwoho Obayiwana, and Mr. Frank Irabo. These men, these women, gave time, gave their talent, gave their ability, committed to the kingdom, committed to the project. And in all of that, can we put our hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen? And the result of that is what we are seeing here today, a very classy, glamorous, colorful, cultural event that the world will talk about in the next several decades. We welcome you one more time. Benedicta is still here. And as soon as His Royal Majesty walks in, and we have His Excellencies, the Governor of the State, and the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, this event will be officially on. One more time, let me say thank you to all of you for your time and patience, particularly our royal fathers that are here. Some have been here since 9 a.m. Patient people. We say thank you to you for your love, for your cooperation with your fellow king.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, sir, the man who sent the population census. I gave the population of Benin, not of Edo State. Edo State, 4 million, yes, but Benin, 1.5, approximately, going by the 2006 population census. My brother just mentioned, acknowledged the committees, the planning committee. There are three planning committees. The other two are the government committee and the finance committee. The government committee is made up of Chief Oseni Elama, the Okaiviore of Benin Kingdom. He is the chairman. Barrister Henry Dahagmo is also there. Prince Clement Agba, a civil commissioner in the state, is there. Architect Francis Ewoma, another commissioner. Chief Tom Uloko is a member of that committee. He's also a commissioner in Edo State. So also is Barrister MacDonald Obasuke. Mr. Moses Obakbolo also makes up that committee. This distinguished audience is also grateful to the Finance Committee for the hard work put in to ensure the success of this momentous event, which is the crowning of the new Oba of Benin. The Finance Committee has as its chairman Engineer Gregory Ero. The vice chairman is Captain Hosa Okumbo. Mr. Alfred Okoegun is a member. So also is Mr. Greg Nwanseru and Mrs. Angela Jide Jones. The Oba is close by. That's the bridge on which he will cross the River Omi. History being enacted, a modern king taking bit by bit the history as performed by his forefathers, by the Obas before him, all 38 Obas before him, He's reenacting every bit of history. So that is the bridge on which the new Oba will cross to Benin. He's not in Benin yet. So he's going to cross that bridge to Benin. Government functionaries, our royal fathers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we want to bring in, I know it's a serious event, it's a happy event, but we want to bring in, to ease some of the tension, Maliki. Maliki, the microphone.
Oba Atope. Oba Atope. I believe we are in a happy mood. I'm very happy to witness this occasion today. Like 1979, my mama said they train whether they go burn me or not. And with this, I want to say, please, let's put our hands together for the women, our mothers that are right here seated. Please, a round of applause. If you are proud of your wife, please hit your hands together. If you know you are happy and she's beautiful. Okay. My Royal Highness and business tycoon, wonderful gentlemen, if you are proud of your queen, your wife, please, the men, clap for them one more time. You know, now the clap, they go, we go know whether you are proud in terms of beauty. Then the men, if you're proud of your wife, oh, sorry, the ladies, if you're proud of your husband, put your hands together for them. If you are proud of him, oh, okay, if he used to give you money, a round of applause for him. I see some of our daddies here. They are not doing it right. All right, like I said, I'm so excited today because this is my first time and I'm about to witness this wonderful occasion. I'm privileged to be here and my name is Maliki. You know, say so why they manage myself, they talk like this. I don't want to go talk the one way I'm not supposed to talk. They go come say, be still till you die. Now like this, I go come there. So I need to maintain my speech. So sorry if I know if I don't know where to come from because the personalities that are seated right here today, if to say they go choose papa, I for choose one way face me so. I guess some kind of father where you go see, you go ask question. Now make it vex me at times when I see my father relating with men way there on top. I ask a question. Where were you? What happened? And later you will come out. Captain Osa is my friend. And you did drive 2K2K? I don't want to welcome that kind of an idea. Say, I used to. I make a struggle as I did. Walk along those people that are making it. If I'm not rich, I'm privileged to be a friend of a rich man. Please, a round of applause for me for that. Abinobiso. I want to call on a wonderful gentleman to continue. And after that, I will come back. Do it right, like you can see, our king is coming. A wonderful man out there. Some people go take picture here today. Go say na their papa de crown. Biological father. For Bini with the rent papa, if he not good. So my Bini brothers right here, you can rent any father here today. Take picture with them. Use their picture, borrow money for bank. There are some people, you just have to take picture with them, use and take a loan. If they ask you, say, see my collateral. So I pray we do it right today. And that's why we are here. If you not behave yourself, now so did they do. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Maliki. I'd like to welcome here your excellencies, our royal fathers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The Honorable Minister of State for Agriculture is here. I'd like to welcome Honorable Anikin Lopobri. He's here with us. And let me, one more time, specially welcome our royal fathers that are here. Let me welcome the man that walked in here with a lot of pomp and pageantry. Let me welcome Obadiye Eniton, Babatunde Ogunwusi, Ajaja II, the All New FIFA. Can we appreciate him, ladies and gentlemen, with his lovely wife, who happens also to be from here. And let me also lick this. I don't know how many kings anywhere in the world that is being coronated on the day that is his birthday. This new king today is his birthday. So we are celebrating not just the man, not just the kingdom, not just the state, we are celebrating Nigeria. Because the kingdom, the Benin kingdom, in terms of influence, in terms of relevance, in terms of symbolism, transcends the shores of this state. But who is this man that we are celebrating today? This amazing king was born in 1953. The former Nigerian ambassador to Norway. And let me add, October 20, 1953. An ambassador. And that's why you will have in him royal diplomacy. Ambassador to Norway, ambassador to Angola. He read economics, he read sociology. He is what you can call the philosopher king, the king that is deep in knowledge, one with his people, and understands global issues. And some of such kind of kings, at that level of intellectualism are here. I'd like to specially welcome here today the Emir of Kano, who's also deep intellectually, former governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, one of the finest financial experts in this country, Emir Muhammadu Sanusi II. Can we appreciate him, ladies and gentlemen? Another very deeply intellectual person is Yobio Fonicha, who's here. I think he even arrived before 9 a.m. I'd like to welcome Your Royal Majesty, Igwe Nnaemeka, Alfred Ugochukwu Achebe. Your work in Nigeria, your contribution to the evolution of our nation, your contribution of the bricks, the stones, the sand to Project Nigeria is highly appreciated. We thank you, Igwe. We also appreciate all of you, our royal fathers that are here, who has come to celebrate one of your own. And like my sister said earlier, 35 years ago, on this very ground, one of the finest monarchs of our time was coronated. Today, history is repeating itself. Today, we are bringing the rich culture of this amazing kingdom to fore. Today, Benin, Edo City, Edo State, is in the global eye. So let me also say this, that this new Oba remains in leading light in both national and international discourse. So today we shall be enthroned in a king that understands his people. That's why it's taking him a while to cross the little bridge. The bridge made of wood that tells us it's like it's a Greek goddess Janus that has two eyes. One looks at the back to remember the history of the people. The other looks to the future to tell the world this is where we are headed. So that's a bridge made of wood. But as it crosses into Benin and crosses into modern life, crosses into modern city, crosses into the life of his people. So I welcome you. I'm very sure if Benedicta is moved by the Spirit, I'm sure she'll come to the microphone.
Go clap for me.
Magodi, Amia mo piani yangu ina bugbo. Igualo yo gualo ereo. Ote pamodi. Izebe oga woniye. Ata garo awa gualo noroa. Izebe oga woniye. Ogo gogare agboru ekwebe. Izebe oga woniye. Wayami osiba o. Owe.
Nana Elenamu. Please, a round of applause for yourself one more time.
talented Maleke. Well done. We are glad to welcome the eldest daughter of the monarch, Princess Mrs. Ikuoyeme Aimiwu Ni Ediawa. Smiling beautifully there, that is the eldest daughter of the Benin monarch. You're welcome. She's here with her baby. We welcome the Chief Commissioner, Scout Association of Nigeria, Olori Omoba Olusoga Sofolahun. You're welcome. The Oba crossing the River Omi Bridge. As Mr. Young pointed out, the bridge constructed with wood. That is the modern Oba reenacting the traditional way of life of his people, as a way of telling us that although we may look up to the future, we must not forget our history. And so unfortunate that these days history is becoming relegated in our secondary schools. But we are glad that so many bodies, so many associations are rising to oppose that stand. That history must remain a focal point of our academic activities. History must remain on the school curricula. Otherwise, when a people forget their history, the future becomes dicey. You need history to remind you of the past and to chart a way forward for a progressive society. Once again, we welcome you all, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, to this very beautiful ceremony, this very cultural ceremony, the crowning of the new Oba of Benin, an event that last took place before today in March 1979, was the last time before today that this event took place. And so we are all very happy. Today is going to be written down in history, and we can beat our chest to say, yes, I was there. So we want to give thanks to God for health, for bringing everyone safely from far and near. Our fathers, all our distinguished guests, have come from the north, they have come from the western parts of the country, they have come from the east, they have come from the south. And so we're all here to witness history being made.
I totally agree with you. It is very historical. And somebody pointed out that what His Royal Majesty, the beaded dress he's wearing, weighs over 20 kg. And a young man of 25, probably a wrestler, cannot wear that and travel 5 kilometers. But this man has done, this our Royal Majesty, striking with it, because right now he is in the hands of the gods. The load gets lighter. So as they paddle across the bridge, I'm coming very, very close to us. We hold our breath as history is in the making. And as somebody corrected my arithmetic earlier, 1979 till date, 37 years, and we are here again on this very land, on this very soil, to put another king that will continue the legacies of the former and chart a new course for the kingdom. So we're here. Again, I welcome all of you. And I'm very sure as now they step in, this event, I'm sure will not last for too long. But today, the rich culture of the Benin people, the headquarters, in fact, global headquarters of cultural artifacts, the bastion and citadel of culture remains intact. And this Oba, this royal majesty that has traversed the whole world is here, set to push the frontiers and raise the bar. One more time on behalf of my colleague, I'd like to welcome all of you on this absolutely wonderful day.
Well, before we call Maleke back to the microphone, as we said earlier, the king, the monarch, the Oba is coming from the Osama Palace. The king has been there for 7 days now, and let's quickly look at the significance of that palace. That palace, which is situated on Siloko Road, for those who know Benin, that palace is on Siloko Road. That was the site of the former palace of the Oba of Benin. That was the site where Oromiyo lived. It was built by him and the first Oba in the Eweka dynasty, or Oba Eweka the First, lived there first in 1200 AD. It was later that that palace was moved to the present site, and that was done by Oba Ewedo. The Usama Palace, we are told, is where Oromiyo lived, and when he needed to return to Ife, he left his pregnant wife, who was the daughter of the Enogie of Eho, of Ego. He left his daughter, and then that pregnant wife, who is or who was the daughter of the Enogie of Ego, was pregnant at the time that he left. And so it turned out that the woman gave birth, but the child could not speak. This is history. The child could not speak. All efforts put in to make him speak proved abortive. And then they sent back to Ife, to his father, the Oromiyo, who sent a special seed, special pebbles, known in Benin as ahwe. He sent that special seed. Ordinarily, it was a game played, an everyday game, but that seed was special. And so, as the then baby played the seed with his contemporaries, others around the palace then, it was just the last seed left. And so he threw it. He threw that special seed from Ife. That is the link the Benins have with Ife. Brothers all the way. So that baby threw that seed. And all of a sudden, the gods opened his mouth. And he proclaimed, Owomika, I have captured it. Owomika was later corrupted to Eweka, that is Eweka the First. Eweka the First began the dynasty that we are in now, and we are witnessing a long line of Obas in that dynasty. And so today we give glory to God that even in the face of modernity, even in the face of technology, this Oba has chosen, like his fathers before him, to carry out all the rites, all the functions, all the rituals that the office demands. So we want to thank God that he has not attempted to modernize anything. If anything, perhaps this hall is the only thing that is modern. Every other thing has remained as it is. And of course, we have the spectacular new palace, which is a state-of-the-art palace. Perhaps that is just the external, but I believe every other thing is as it is. So it's a mixture of the ancient and the modern. We do not necessarily need to live in the past. We use the past to shape the present and the future. And that is what this Oba signifies. He shows that he's a modern king, he's a king who looks forward to the future, he's a king who acknowledges the importance of technology, he's a king who takes seriously the importance of science, despite his reliance on history, despite his reliance on the things that were done before. I'm being told that the personalities to receive the vice president should please step forward now. Please go out. The vice president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria is almost here. The designated functionaries would step out to receive the number two citizen of Nigeria. Okay. Let me just run through. To receive the Vice President, the Deputy Governor of Edo State, Dr. Pius Egberame Odubu, His Royal Highness, Prince Professor G.I. Akenzua, Engineer Dr. Greg Ero, General Godwin Abe, Chief Elama Oseni, Ambassador Imohe, Ambassador Dan Hart, and Chief Igbe, the Iyase of Benin Kingdom.
So while those eminent people step out to welcome His Excellency the Vice President, let me also acknowledge the presence in our midst of the Deputy Governor of Imo State, His Excellency Prince Eze Madumere. And let me also welcome here several of the gubernatorial candidates that just concluded election in Edo State are here. The ABGA candidate, El Osarona, who is also here with us, with his amazing team. Let me welcome all of you, especially in a few minutes, like I said earlier, as soon as our Excellencies and the Royal Majesty walk in, this event will kick off.
We welcome also the Catholic Archbishop of the Benin Catholic Archdiocese, His Grace, Most Reverend Augustine Akubeze. You're welcome.
I'd like to welcome him, the chairman of Obat Petroleum, a titan indeed in the private sector before he went to the palace. Let me welcome specially a man that considers some of us his children, His Imperial Majesty, Obat Dr. Frederick Obateru Akinrutan, CON, Okoro Ejiga I, Olugbo of Ugwuland. I'd like to thank Professor Victor Wai for here, one of those icons that represents the very best of not just Benin Kingdom, but Edo State. But he just came here to tell me that you've been speaking, but we don't know who you are. My name is Ebere Young, and it's my pleasure to work with Benedicta here as we pilot this event to the very end. Today, I can tell my grandchildren. I couldn't have been able to say so in 1979, but I could tell them that as we put on the throne the 39th Oba of Benin, a man of class and education, I was also standing on that same very ground. So I welcome all of you. In a few minutes, we will kick these events off as we begin to celebrate the very essence of culture and tradition, as we begin to celebrate the history and heritage of the amazing people of Benin and, by extension, Edo State, as we begin to interrogate the very essence and legacy of monarchies across the world. Today, the monarchical system is on the front burner, still relevant, still part of our existence, still part of our history. So as the new Oba walks in His Royal Majesty, and we await their presence, His Excellency is the Governor of the State, his lovely wife, and the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, will be starting off in a few minutes.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I've been told to go beyond the historical account that I was given, to go to the very beginning. And so what is the very beginning? I'm talking about the history of Benin. The history of Benin monarchy, not the history of anywhere else. And so before Oromiyo, history has it. History of the monarchy has it that a prince of this kingdom, a Kaladera, for one reason or the other, a Kaladera was banished from this kingdom. He was abandoned in this kingdom, and he went to a place. He went to a place that is now known in history as Ife. He went to that place where he was received warmly, and then he chose the name Izoduwa. That was the name that he chose. And so history also has it that when there was some challenges in Benin Kingdom, necessitating that the rightful heir to the throne be installed in this kingdom, the people sent to Ife, because their prince, that they had now discovered, that they had thought was lost but had been found, their prince who left this kingdom because of certain happenings in this kingdom and went to Ife, their prince was in Ife. And so from this kingdom, they sent that he comes home to ascend the throne. History also has it that at the time that he was sent for, he was too old to come. And so he sent his son, Oromiyo, in Benin, known as Omononya. And so Oromiyo came to Benin. That is where I started from before. It was when he felt that he could not understand certain things with the people here that he left. He went back to Ife. At the time that he left, his wife was already in the family way and gave birth to Eweka the First. Thank you very much.
I think we need to celebrate her. She's a daughter of the soil, retired from NTA lectures at the University of Benin. And so we need to celebrate Benedicta. Amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Benedicta.
welcome His Royal Highness Enoge Idu Akenzua, the Enoge of Oroba Base. You're welcome, Your Royal Highness. Approaching here, and please, if you are Bini, join me to sing this song. Oge ngade oye wuki oye wongwe era nodia e na ya bo wegwa e. Oge ngade oye wuki oye wongwe era nodia e na ya bo wegwa e. Oge made oye wuki oye wongwe era nodia e na ya bo wegwa e. Thank you very much. We appreciate very much our traditional father, all the way from Sokoto, His Eminence Alhaji Muhammad Saad Abubakar III, CFR, our royal father. We respect you, sir.
Please, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please, I will rise to welcome His Excellency, the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. We also welcome His Excellency the Governor of Edo State, Comrade Adams Oshomole here. And so, Your Excellencies, let's all be seated now. In a few minutes, His Royal Majesty will be here. We will take the national anthem and start officially. Let me also welcome His Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Imo State, representing Owele Rocha as Okorocha of Imo State. Prince Eze Madumere is also here with us. I'd like to welcome you. His Excellency, His Royal Majesty, is just a stone throw from here. Once he walks in, we'll take the national anthem and this event will start.
We also welcome the Governor-elect of Edo State, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, who by the grace of God, from the 10th of November this year, will be sworn in as governor. Is almost here, and as my colleague pointed out, the people have taken ownership of him, finding it difficult to wade through the crowd to get here. We can see some of the landmarks around this arena. We are seeing those landmarks already, so it's almost here. It's just that movement appears cumbersome because of the crowd, sheer crowd. I remember one of the days we walked with him from Uselu, the palace of the Edaiken Nuselu. We walked on that day from that palace to the city center, to the present palace. It was a sheer nightmare to go through the crowd that accompanied him, not to talk about all those who lined the routes to acknowledge our royal father. On that day, Benin City stood still as everyone wanted to catch a glimpse of the then Crown Prince, who today will be formally crowned as the Oba of Benin Kingdom. Is within this vicinity. We can see some of the landmarks around Uropota and the museum ground. He's almost here. It's not been easy. He left on foot the Usama Palace, where he has been for 7 days, where he has continued to perform all the rites, all the rituals as done by his forebears. From there, 2 days ago, he went to Use to choose a name that will be unveiled to us at this ceremony. And so this morning, he took off again from the same Usama Palace, and he's coming with his people, a monarch that is loved by his people, a monarch who loves his people. And so they are coming with him all the way from Usama Palace through Isekere, crossing River Omi, paddling there, and arriving in Benin. And so they are within this vicinity. Very shortly, the Ekasa Royal Troop will usher in the new Oba. Once again, we welcome His Excellency, the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, a professor of law, a senior advocate of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo. Welcome, sir. We welcome also a man that is now being referred to as the Odolewo of Benin Kingdom, His Excellency Governor Adams Oshomole, who runs off his 8-year tenure in less than 1 month from now. You're welcome, Your Excellency. And like I said earlier, this function that he's performing today may be the last big official function of His Excellency, the presentation of the staff of office to the new Oba of Benin. The governor, by the way, has been a respecter of custom, a respecter of tradition. He has held the monarchy, he has held all the traditional institutions in this state in high esteem, for which the people appreciate you, Your Excellency.
Also in our midst, in this culturally rich city, is Africa's richest man. I'd like to welcome the president of the Dangote Group, Elijah Aliko Dangote, Jisu, and he's here with us. I welcome you.
Do about when I do. Oh, give a do about when I do. Why be a devil do about when I do. I will get any river do about when I do. I will any receipt do about when I do. Easy when I do. Oba we nu wado, wabukya do. Oba we nu wado, izegbe na o do. Oba we nu wado, awo kima o do. Oba we nu wado, obi dolevo do. Oba we nu wado, oba tokpe
ise.
Oh,
Respect his monarch, our revered monarch, any minute from now. The monarch, when he comes, we all shudder. In fact, there's a Benin song that talks about the myth surrounding the Oba, that talks about the esteem with which the Oba is held. In fact, in Benin, they hardly see the Oba. In those days, they hardly see the Oba. So they would say, "Opo unu nekpo wa o." You talk about the Oba all the time, but you hardly see the Oba. Maliki, join me. Goba, goba, goba. Goba ugboriri. Goba, goba, goba. Goba ugboriri, goba goba goba,
goba ugboriri.
You talk about the Benin King, but you don't see him all the time. So it's a special privilege that we are seeing the new Oba. We are all part of the making of history. We are seeing a new Oba as he is being crowned today. He has chosen a name which will be unveiled very shortly. That name is known to no other than him, perhaps at this time. And so at his crowning, the Oliha pronounces his new name, by which he will now be known and by which his children will be known. Goba, 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 goba,
ugboriri.
The information we're getting is that in a few minutes, His Royal Majesty will walk into this arena. But let me also quickly welcome distinguished Senator Francis Ali Mikena, representing the President of the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Ewo no yele do agimye wo tagmo e matana ipo baireko emota erekanu iya no legado agimye wewebo o edo yaye
do Ado, ado, ado meno paje. E wo no je ado, agi mi e wo tagmo. E matana, iko baireko, e mo ta erekanu. Iya no le gado, agi mi e wepo. O edo ya ye.
Aga sawedo edo dio o edo ga sogoma edo dio o aga sawedo edo ga dio o edo ga sogoma o edo ga dio o
what all right there.
Just before the Oba enters the arena, his three queens will take their seat. They are Queen Iogama, the first queen. She's the Oba Zwaye Nerie. Queen Iyayota, the Oba Zuwa Nerie, and Queen Ikpakpa, the Oherie. They will take their seat. Once again, we welcome the governor-elect of Edo State, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, who is here with his lovely wife. You are most welcome. We welcome once again also the Honorable Minister of Information, Alhaji Lai Mohammed. Welcome also a son of the soil, a Minister of State for Health, Dr. Osagie Ehanire, is also here with his lovely wife. You're welcome, Honorable Minister. The people who are staying around us here, we are told that what is delaying the Queen's coming in is because you are all around us here. You know that is another unique feature of the Benin tradition. No man goes close to the wife of the Oba except the children, except the sons. No man, no adult male goes close to the wife of the Oba of Benin. And so please, all the men who are around us here, please find a more comfortable place and relocate.
Not to you, our royal fathers.
Our royal fathers.
Not to you.
Thank you.
And I've also been given special visa to also remain here. Or else Benedicta will have done this event alone.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it's a mark of honor that the Oba, our Oba, has various appellations for which he is known. Apart from the new name that he will take, there are various praise names, if you call them. Some of them include Omonoba Nedo Uku Akpolokpolo, which is very well known to us. We also refer to him as Obie Biokpa Nokpain Gweni. We also refer to our Oba as Obiada Obieben. Our Oba is also the Odiode Nohaemwete. We welcome you, sir, Captain Hosa Okumbo, a captain of industry, and Dr. Greg Ero. Our Oba is also the Obiekenekene Madoyo. He's also the Okpawu Nunekpo Wao. Our Oba is also the Ekmenowa Nebemiku. Vice President, sir, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, Edo State Governor, who is here with his beautiful wife, Mrs. Iara Oshomole. We are happy to welcome you to this event. I'm sure you'd be very happy witnessing this for the first time. You'd have a lot of stories to tell. We welcome all distinguished fathers here, our royal fathers, the Sultan of Sokoto, the Oni of Ife, the Emir of Kano, the Olu of Wari, the Oroje of Okpe, the Obi of Onitsha, the Etsunupe, all our royal fathers, you are all very special, you are all very welcome to this event.
male and two females. What are some of these songs?
What a day that is unfolding before our very eyes. Again, I think our greatest gratitude will go to our royal fathers that have been here for hours. The King Jaja of Okpobo has been here. The Obong of Calabar has been here. The Olu of Warri has been here all day. The Olugbo of Ugbo, who's probably one of the richest monarchs on our continent, has been here all morning. All of you, our royal fathers, we say thank you to all of you for being here to celebrate one of your kind. We thank you. sure they are getting closer to us. But let me very quickly welcome His Royal Highness as Dr. Matthew E. Onwenu, Deputy Chairman, Imo State Council of Ndeze, and Chairman Okive Zo, Council of Ndeze. Okive, welcome.
Royal Queens of the new Oba of Benin are making their regal entry into the arena. Please put your hands together. Thank you, sir. Put your hands together. Our queens. We have Queen Iogama, Yoba Zwaye Neri. We have Queen Iyayota, the Obazuwa Neri, and we have Queen Ikpapa Uheneri. They are with us to witness the formal coronation of the Oba of Benin and the presentation of staff of office to him by the state government. Staff of office of the first class traditional union. wala wade du wa eva wa ihano wade wadwa vie go na ya mja oba ha wade wala ho Welcome a member of the House of Representatives, Omosede Igbinedion. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Amonoba Nedo Uku Akolokolo. No Utete, no Uwe Soma. Ope Doya Natokbe. Your Excellency, the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo. Your Excellency, the Speaker of the House of Representatives, here represented. Your Excellency, the Host Governor, Comrade Adam Nshomale, and other state governors, here represented. The Governor-elect of Edo State, Mr. Godwin Obaseki. My Lords, spiritual, temporal, and all my Lords here present. Our Royal Fathers here present. Members of the Diplomatic Corps. Members of National and State Assemblies here present. Members of the Federal and State Executive Councils here present. Local government chairmen and functionaries. Other top government functionaries. Captains of industry. The Benin Royal Family. Friends and associates of His Majesty the Oba of Benin. Worldwide. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. We are happy to receive the monarch, the new Oba of Benin, as we go straight to invite the Uzama chiefs, led by Chief Oliha, to perform the necessary rites, culminating in the final coronation of the Oba of Benin, the Uzama chiefs. Appreciate them as they come forward. Appreciate them. They come forward to crown the Obiada Obiaden. And no Utete, no Uvesoma. Opawao, no Titi, Sobio. Opa, Atokbe. That's Chief Oliha leading the Uzama Chief. Also known as the Dion.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Your Excellency. Your Excellency. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Crowned before you, Your Excellencies, is a king in his majestic splendor that will transform the tone and contours of this traditional stool. A king that will impose his personality, his sense of duty, his dedication on the throne. A king that will traverse his domain with enduring royal diplomacy. He will bring peace. He will heal the land. And for 8 years, one man has also transversed this state with what I could call democratic diplomacy. It's my honor and pleasure, Your Excellencies, Royal Fathers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, to invite here His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Edo State, Comrade Adams and Liu Shomole, CONMNI, for his address.
Excellency, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Commander-in-Chief of the Nigerian Armed Forces, President Muhammadu Buhari, who is today very ably and competently represented by the Vice President, His Excellency, Professor Pastor Yemi Osinbajo, PCOM. Your Royal Majesty, the Oba of Benin, Omonoba Ledo Uku Akolokolo, the Oba of the greatest kingdom on this planet.
Lord of the Lord! Lord of the Lord!
My brother governors who have traveled from various parts of the country to be here this afternoon, not in a particular order, whether alphabetical order or in order of height or experience or age. I appreciate my brother accountant town governor, the governor of Gombe State, the governor of Osu State, the man who appropriated the word of Ogbeni to become personal to him, Ogbeni Rao Arikwesola, my brother from Oyo State, Governor Amosu, all the deputy governors here present, particularly the deputy governor of Edo State, the deputy governor of Imo State, honorable ministers, the representative of the Senate President, and the representative of the Speaker of Edo State of National Assembly, the Speaker of Edo State House of Assembly and members of Edo State House of Assembly, our highly respected royal fathers from across the country, it would be impossible for me to attempt to mention your names, but you will allow me the privilege to acknowledge our joy in having with us this afternoon the foremost royal father that combined royalty with the leadership as a religious leader, the Sultan of Sokoto, Saad Abubakar. Allow me also to appreciate a royal father with rare combination, a banker of repute, and now the Sariki Kano, the Emir of Kano. Sanusi Lamido Sanusi. Allow me to acknowledge our royal father, the Oni of Ife. And of course, His Royal Highness Esunupe, Alhaji Dr. Yahaya Abubakar, who I also want to appreciate as Chancellor of the Best University in Nigeria, Abusali University. There are several royal fathers here, including the Obi of Onitsha. You allow me to stop here and appreciate all your royal majesties that are here and your royal highnesses. But I cannot fail to mention my own royal father, the Otaru of Aochi Kingdom, Ikelebe II. I'm sure Governor Amos, Governor Ajimobi and I, we will settle around Okuparibu when I am at the bottom. We will have time to retaliate. Your Royal Majesty, for me, is such a great honor and a very rare privilege on behalf of the government and the people of our state to be part of this historic epoch-making event and the privilege of welcoming all of you who have traveled from across the length and breadth of Nigeria, including ambassadors from Europe, from America, from Asia, from around the world. Your presence here bears testimony to the unique position which the Oba of Benin occupies in the affairs of our great state and of Benin Kingdom. The formal coronation of Your Royal Majesty today afford us the opportunity to renew and to celebrate the rich cultural tradition of Benin Kingdom and to showcase the beauty and the uniqueness not only of this great kingdom but of Edo State. Conclude the formal coronation of a new Oba to recall very fond memories the
outstanding
contributions
and royalty that Oba Eledeyawa
displayed
while on the throne.
I recall with fond memories my very privileged relationship
that was like that of a father and a son. And if you come from my kind of background,
you will appreciate how much that meant to me.
He was there for me
as an applicant.
Seeking job,
he was there for me as the governor of this great state.
He readily counseled me
on a number of issues,
sometimes even in writing.
He demonstrated what I learned in my primary school.
But kings have more ears than one,
and they have more eyes than two.
They hear everything that happens in the kingdom
and they see everything that happens everywhere in the kingdom. Because those who see and report to him, he has seen what they saw. And those who hear and inform him, he has heard what they heard. All of this His Royal Majesty brought to my attention and it helped me a great deal to deal with a number of issues without which to accomplish the much that I believe we were able to contribute to the development not only of this kingdom but of our great state. He will be remembered as a king who intervened, and that intervention makes the difference. As I was driving in today with our vice president, he asked me, when was the airport road transformed to 6-lane? And I tried to brief him how and when. But that intervention was only made possible by His Royal Majesty, who has now joined his ancestors, writing to the parliament to ask them to support the governor to make the construction of that road possible. I remain eternally grateful, and I'm sure I speak the minds of the great people of this state to say that his contribution remains indelible in our heart and in our minds. But
But today's event is to celebrate the formal coronation of a new Oba. And I believe that we are also extremely fortunate to have a new Oba who has been very well groomed, tutored, and mentored by his father in the finest of royal tradition. These qualities he has already displayed as a Daikenu Selu. And for all those who have had the rare privileges, as I have had, to interact with Your Majesty, we have no doubt in our mind that you have what it takes to step into the big royal shoes left by your great father, or by Rediawa. Not only are you very well schooled, you are also, Your Majesty, extremely well exposed, not only in administration, but in diplomacy. Your Majesty, you have served our great country at our most difficult period as a nation, as ambassador to most strategic countries in Europe. And in the course of your duty, I had the privilege, even as a Protestant, to be received and protected by you in a foreign country. Nothing suggests then that I will be here today. You can see that I just simply have the words to convey the depth of my gratitude, of my pride, and my confidence that this kingdom under your reign can only grow from strength to strength. Your Royal Majesty, even before I became the governor of this state, I have benefited enormously from your wisdom. I, not being a royal, you accorded me courtesies that are uncommon of a royal personage. You have even publicly adopted me as a privileged son and part of the royal family. That I will always celebrate. I believe the people of this kingdom, the greatest kingdom on the planet, Benin Kingdom, and the people of this great state, the heartbeat of our great nation, and I know the Vice President will confirm that. Without a doubt, there can be no Nigeria. We are really the heartbeat. I joined millions of Edo people and of Nigerians, and indeed your admirers around the world, to congratulate you on this occasion and to join in asking God and our ancestors to grant you all the wisdom that Your Majesty will need to succeed in this most exalted position as Oba of this great kingdom. I also join to ask God to give you the good health that you need to provide and to preside over the affairs of this kingdom. And I think as we watch the events on television, what Your Majesty has had to go through, several kilometers walking through to this throne, you have shown that you understand life. You have mingled with very ordinary people. You have shown a common capacity to interact and socialize both vertically and horizontally. It cannot be better. I believe, therefore, that all I need to say to conclude is to reassure you that for the remaining few days I have, as your steward, I shall give my all. And I do believe I speak the mind of the governor-elect. We have laid a foundation and a standard. We have demonstrated practically that Nigeria democracy requires that we bond effectively with traditional institutions. That our relationship between elected government and the traditional institution should not be based on ad hoc interaction. But we should formalize it, structure it in a way, and make it functional. It has worked over the past 8 years. I believe the governor-elect, Godwin Obaseki, will build on it and will take it to a higher level. Your Royal Majesty, work it together. I think God designed it to be this way, and our ancestors. Your Majesty will be assuming office just a few days before the end of my tenure, also a few days before the assumption of duty of a brand new governor of this great state. He has assured me he understands tradition even much more than myself. So whatever I was able to do, he will do even better. Whatever relationship I have cultivated between the government of this state and the traditional institution, particularly the Oba of Benin, the Benin Palace, and indeed all the royal fathers in this state, he will do even more. Working together, this state shall continue to grow from strength to strength. May you reign for a long, long time. And may this kingdom witness more and more progress. Even when I will have retired in the next few days, I want to be able to say that I maintain my privileges as a village boy adopted by the royal to continue to interact and to benefit from your leadership of this great kingdom. I want once again to thank all of you royal fathers. I don't have the words to describe my feeling. It is not every day that you have such a collection of highly placed first-class chiefs from the north, from the south, from the west, and from the east. The whole world is here. Your Royal Highnesses, may God bless you. May God bless your kingdom. May God grant you travel mercies back to your various places at the end of today's event. And for my brothers and sisters across party divide, the Oba of Benin unified all of us as one huge, large political party, the party of Edo Kingdom. That we all belong. No division, no faction. I will remain faithful to that party that covers all of us. It remains for me to say to you, sir, Oba Atokpaye, Omonoba Wato Wakpaye. Now allow me to appreciate the fact that I am here with my wife. No verse. Thank you very much.
And so, Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me now invite His Excellency the Governor to present the staff of office to the Royal Majesty. Your Excellency.
Your Majesty, Excellencies, our Royal Fathers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, may I now at this point invite His Royal Majesty Omonoba Nedo Ukwu Akpolopolo to address his people. Omonoba will now address his people.
The grace of God Almighty, and in the name of our ancestors, I welcome you all to this auspicious occasion. In particular, I welcome His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR Head of State, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Nigeria, here represented by the very, very able Vice President, Professor Osibanjo. You're welcome. President of the Senate, here represented, Speaker of the House of Representatives, Chief Justice of the Federation, Your Excellencies, Comrade Adams Aliyu Oshomoli, the indefatigable governor of Edo State. In a few days, we will be very sad to have you go, because you have done very well for Edo State. No doubt, you have said it all, that your successor will do as much as possible to try and fill your own big shoes that you'll be leaving behind. Thank you for letting the world know that I'm already filling my father's big shoes. I hope the governor-elect will do his best to fill your shoes. Your Majesties, traditional rulers and chiefs who have come from far and near, in particular, the Sultan of Sokoto, His Eminence, the Sultan of Sokoto, the Emir of Kano, the Oni of Ife, the Obi of Onisha, forgive me if I cannot run through the whole list. You are all most welcome. Members of the National and State Assemblies here present, my Lords, Spiritual and Temporal, Excellencies, members of the Diplomatic Corps, members of the media, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the events of today mark the end of activities prescribed by customs and tradition for my accession to the revered throne of this ancient kingdom. I accept with faith and humility the destiny which ordained that henceforth I shall be the embodiment and expression of the culture, aspirations, and history of our people. As the principal actor in the events of several months that led to this awesome position, I've had a unique opportunity to reflect on the values and essence of our historical continuum. What royalty represents for our people are justice, peace, and unity. These ideals shall be reawakened and will be sustained in the dispensation that will soon unfold. The time-tested, rank-of-free succession process bequeathed to us in our customs and tradition is a great tribute to the far-sightedness and wisdom of our forefathers and our people. This collective achievement is a veritable proof of our ability to manage our own affairs. It makes us very proud of our heritage. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me begin by paying deserved tribute to my illustrious father, Omonoba Nedo Ukuakpolokpolo Irediawa CFR, who joined our ancestors after 37 years of glorious reign. With all due modesty, I must admit that as his son and heir, I enjoyed and benefited from his fatherly love and wisdom more than anyone else. His visionary leadership, courage, and dedication to the protection of our cultural heritage ensured that the legacy of several centuries was preserved. He was a true symbol of our cultural identity. Throughout his reign, the palace was a warm and welcome home to all who had need for good counsel, guidance, and material assistance. Traditional rulers from far and near consulted him for clarity on touchy issues or to resolve a vast range of socio-cultural problems. Ethnicity, religion, and social values, social status were no barriers to reaching him for advice or support. He was a good and caring father to us all. He led our common cause with dignity, tact, and wisdom. In the committee of royalties, he was exemplary, and hence he was revered throughout his kingdom and beyond. Although for him, culture and tradition occupied the pride of place, he was open to new ideas and respectful of progress made through social and scientific innovations.
Oba Atope.
Time constraint will not allow me to give a full account of all my father's achievements or the benefits of his reign brought to Benin Kingdom, Edo State, our country, and indeed to humanity. His life of service is simply captured in the title of his own autobiography, I Remain, Sir, Your Obedient Servant. His views and wise counsel on several issues affecting man and society are well documented in his work, Cradle of Ideas, a compendium of speeches and writings of Omonoba Eredawa of Great Benin. These two literary works give some insight into the monumental legacy that is now left for us. Our responsibility from now on is daunting, but I am confident that with the blessing of God Almighty, the love and support of my family, my people, Nigerians in general, and my international friends in the international community, we shall succeed in this life mission of building upon the legacies of our father. Let me crave your indulgence to also make a few remarks about my late mother, Princess Ikoyeme Akinzua, of blessed memory, who passed on to the great beyond in 1976, when my father was still the crown prince. It was my dear mother who taught me to work hard for success in everything I set my mind upon to achieve. Circumstances and hands of fate did not allow her to enjoy the status of a queen in her lifetime, but she was a princess in her own right. By my coronation today, she is now qualified to be bestowed with the title of Iyoba. Which means Queen Mother. Which custom allows us to confer posthumously. This will be consummated at the appropriate time. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please, if you don't mind, be upstanding to join me for a minute silence in honor of this wonderful sweet mother and great father.
Papa, talk to him.
May their gentle souls continue to guide and protect us. Amen. Reminiscences are not just for sentiment, because the experiences reinforce in us the importance of history. History also reminds us of the importance of the present time, which is the only opportunity we have to take the different and too often fragmented components of our collective past to prepare the foundation for a unified and collective future. The long line of succession of kings in the kingdom known as Benin started in the 12th century by modern reckoning. There may be some different views about the origin of some of our ancestors, but there is unanimity in the shared heritage between the peoples of Benin and Ile-Ife in identifying Oduduwa as a forebear of kingship in many kingdoms in part of Africa called Nigeria today. Historians all agree that Oduduwa sent his son Oromiya at the request of elders of Benin to return with them as ruler of their realm. Oromiya's stay in Benin may have been short, but before he left, a child was born to him, who was later crowned Oba. And as is known today, and is known today as Eweka I. Oromiya's time in Benin, however short-lived, he was an Oba. And so he was the first Oba after the Ogiso dynasty came to an end. He established Obaship in Benin. By implication, therefore, the listing of past Obas should therefore begin from Oromiya, as it is listed in the Garawa's book. Short history of Benin, actually making my revered father 39th Oba that reigned in Benin, if the listing is counted from and should be counted from Oromiya. I therefore stand before you today as the 40th Oba of Benin. A direct descendant of Oromiya, the son of Oduduwa, whom the Benin people of that era knew as a Kaladiran, their self-exiled prince, who later became ruler in Ile-Ife, the Benin people recognize Oduduwa and his origin, but it is not our place to force this recognition on others outside our boundaries. The history of the world is a shared one, and there will certainly be unexpected connections in future. This is thus a time for unity and not divisiveness. A time for mutual respect, recognizing that our wholeness as people is so much more than the sum of our parts. E pluribus unum. Now, what does the new dispensation hold for us? The Oba remains the channel through which the powers of the ancestors continue to guide and protect the kingdom and its people.
Oba Atope!
To that extent, we shall faithfully discharge this sacred responsibility. We shall pay due attention to all members of custom and tradition, focusing on real issues of security of our communities and the welfare and development of our people. We shall carry out reforms in palace administration in order to be adequately responsive to our people's sincere and deep longing for justice, equity, and stability. We shall strive to ensure that conflicts are resolved between individuals, families, and communities along the principles of social justice. We shall use cultural diplomacy as a veritable tool for the promotion of harmonious relationships with our neighbors far and near. I also strongly advise my Benin people to strive to maintain our culture, especially our language, by insisting on its use in communicating with their children and each other. You will agree with me that Benin Empire, which encompassed part of Lagos across to Asaba, even then Dahomey, has now shrunk to within only one state. To survive, it is imperative that we maintain our culture, which is now the only unifying force for our people. Our culture and tradition remains the one main factor that the entire country and international community respects us for. I appeal to our Benin people to uphold and respect our traditional institution at all times. I implore government also to include Edo language and Benin history in our schools' curriculum. We shall forge links with the other traditional institutions here in Nigeria, in Africa, and beyond. We must especially acknowledge how honored and gratified we are to have in our midst today representatives of monarchs from other parts of the world. The Zulu King in South Africa, the Kabaka of the Kingdom of Burgundy, as well as the Queen of England and the monarchs of Sweden, Denmark, and Norway, are all represented at this event by the ambassadors of their respective countries. I hope this will provide an opportunity to strengthen contacts and build linkages that will complement and enhance excellent bilateral relationships that already exist between our countries. We shall uphold and maintain the principle of neutrality and non-partisanship in political party activities. While our people remain free to play politics by subscribing to any political party of their choice, we shall, however, continue to pray for and we always support the right kind of political leaders who will safeguard the welfare of our people, provide for their basic needs, and who will accord due recognition to traditional institutions. We will initiate a cultural renaissance that will focus on tourism promotion through arts and crafts. To drive this initiative, we have already established two special purpose vehicles, namely the Benin Royal Dynasty Trust will, in collaboration with Benin Traditional Council, establish a foundry or two in Iguayamo quarters to enhance the productivity of the Bronze Casters Guild. Benin Royal Academy for Performing Arts will train youths and develop their talents. They will reach out to international choreographers in different parts of the world for the purpose of transforming Benin dance drama into an international brand. Through these initiatives, we hope to attract tourism to our land and provide jobs for our teeming youths. We shall also support efforts to build partnerships and seek international assistance for the restoration of Benin monuments, including revival of the creative and artistic talents of Beninese, which are already globally acknowledged through our rich artifacts. It is pertinent at this point to express our deep concern about the pervasive poverty at the grassroots and the astronomical rise in crime and juvenile delinquency in our society. The problem is both a consequence of and is aggravated by widespread youth unemployment. This solution will require a well-articulated and structured youth development and empowerment programs with active support of government at all levels. We shall partner with the government to attract domestic and international resources.
Homage. The chiefs will pay homage, followed by the royal family and other citizens to pay homage to the new king. The chiefs are paying homage to the new monarch, Omonoba Nedo Uku Akpolokpolo, Oba Ewae Nogieva, Oba Ewae the Second, Ewae the Great of Benin Kingdom. We are happy to be witnessing history. We are happy to be part of this making of history. The royal family, pay your homage to the monarch, followed by other citizens.
While the chiefs are paying homage, let me announce again that we'll have the Durbar 9 a.m. at the palace tomorrow, and then an art exhibition, Art of Benin Kingdom, will also be holding at 6 p.m. tomorrow at the Oba Kinzwa Cultural Center, Benin City. The chiefs are still paying homage, and in a minute or two, we will be calling for the national anthem. And the royal family also paying homage. Today we celebrate a new king. Today we celebrate a new beginning. Today the Benin Kingdom is our washing hope and expectation.
All the Masons want to pay homage. The Masons.
And then the Masons are also moving forward to also go and pay homage. So let them step forward now. Like I said earlier, while we pay homage, the Durbar will hold 9 a.m. tomorrow at the palace, and also the art exhibition will hold at 6 p.m. also at the Oba Kenzua Cultural Center. And then for all of the people invited, there is reception immediately at the palace. There is reception immediately at the palace. Again, let me remind you, we have the Durbar 9 a.m. at the palace and the art exhibition, Art of Benin Kingdom, at the Oba Kenzua Cultural Center, 6 p.m. tomorrow. And we'd like to thank King Okurakpo. He's actually consolidating the relationship between Bayelsa and Benin Kingdom. And so on the 22nd, which is 2 days from now, 11:30 a.m., at the Oba's Palace, the Okugwe Soko Kingdom cultural troupe will be performing all the way from the glory of our land, Bayelsa, and right here, in the heartbeat of the nation.
After the national anthem, the people will escort the Oba Ewoye II to the palace. The palace waits expectantly for His Royal Majesty Oba Ewoye II, and his people will escort him to the palace. This is the people's Oba, the Oba who is expected to make giant strides for the development of this kingdom. So we'll start by going with him to the palace. The Masons are lining up to pay homage to the Oba.